We're going to be harnessing the heat and cooling of the earth to basically get our air conditioning and cooling for our house.
When we first bought this place, I think most people probably would have torn this house down. For old house people, you're trying to bring your house back to a look of a certain time period.
But we're using Thermal Associates. They're in upstate New York.
We picked geothermal for a few reasons. The first was economical. We wanted to basically have the lowest operating costs over 20, 25 years in the house for heating and cooling. Number two is the air conditioner unit is inside. There's nothing on the outside. There's no mini splits. There's nothing on the outside. So the whole landscape is retained in its beauty. Can we show you the geothermal unit? This is all it is. There's no external condenser, there's no air conditioning unit, and it's running throughout the whole outside ground loop.
This whole area, and it kind of loops around and feeds back into the basement. So it's just a continuous kind of loop.
We are here on dig day. My buddy Tony is helping dig this trench.
So all of this pipe will heat and cool our house.
And they come into our basement here and then cycle over to the unit.
Then one goes in and one is going out back into the field.
So it's cycling.
So it's cycling constantly. Now the loops themselves are good for like 50 years, potentially up to 100 years. And as architectural preservationists, we care about what these buildings look like. And here we have a lot of ducts, yes, but they're all hidden.
We do have to run some ducts up to get upstairs, and what we're going to do with that is we're just going to clad them in millwork so they look like they're just part of the house, part of the walls.
They just get hidden, and this is going to service the whole upstairs. This is the main trunk line for the heating system.
You have the primary house, which is that front of the house facing the barn. This is an extension on the back, and then there's another wing going off the side, making sure that we're heating everything equally, but also having options in terms of what we want to heat at what time.
And what's also cool is that we're not worried about bursting pipes. And that was always a concern that they would burst if we were traveling and there wasn't any control for those pipes. We can be notified, we can check out what the temperature is, and we can bring it up, we can bring it down, we can have the unit serviced. It's nice to just have some of those modern conveniences.
Definitely was a higher upfront cost, but our energy costs in the long run will be lower. And this is a really good sustainable solution for an old house, which is always important to us.
And right now there's tax breaks to really make this affordable for people to kind of get over that initial hump. We get a tax break on all of it. So it actually cuts the cost down to half.
Check out what your state might be offering, because I mean, for us to get 50% off of the cost of installation of this system is a lot. It is not a cheap system.
People are pushing towards this technology as a new way of heating and cooling our houses. And I think sustainably long term, we're not just looking at this as being stewards for this old house. We're looking at being stewards for the next generation.